I've come up with a procedure that will connect the subclavian artery to the pulmonary artery, and it works.
It kind of ruins my joke, but I guess we can go with your idea.
Well, I put my heart into it, so, no? All right, nothing. Okay.
Even though he was a surgical prodigy who was teaching his techniques to the doctors, he was still paid only as a technician. News spread quickly of the innovations pioneered by Thomas and Blaylock, or as they were known in the press, Blaylock. Johns Hopkins University in Baltimore invited Blaylock to be their new head of surgery, and he knew he needed Thomas to come with. But Baltimore was pretty segregated then. The only black employees were janitors.
Listen, Viv, I know you're disappointed you still can't afford medical school, but what does doctor mean anyway? It's just a title. The point is, you're gonna be respected for your work right here.
Oh, somebody get a doctor. Oh.
Can I help?
Yes, get a mop and find a doctor. Oh. And put those back where you found them. I don't know where you picked those up, but they're not for you. Oh!
I can't even believe this.
I don't think he intends to get them off.
Soon, Dr. Blaylock was performing the revolutionary procedures pioneered by Thomas. But even he knew he couldn't get through it without his secret weapon by his side.
Today, I will be among the first to operate on the human heart itself. But no, please, hold your applause until the end in case the patient dies.
What?
Whoa, oh, more anesthesia. And there we go. First, I will make an incision here. Yeah, now, once we pass the vena cava and transect the pulmonary artery, then we proceed to the... Oh, my gosh, what is all of that? That's the subclavian artery. Now, you want to be careful because you don't want to nick anything. Whoa, oh, boy, that's a mess. That's not good. That's not good. But again, yeah, okay, all right.
Doctor, your hands.
What?
Your gloves have fallen off.
Oh,
let me get you some new ones.
Oh, of course, yeah. I'll just put that in my mouth. Here we go. There's one little pause for a second. They're awfully hard to get on. Oh, boy, those babies are tight. Well, that's much, much better.
Phew!
Now, let's get to some cutting. Okay, here we go. And diving in. Now, that's the ticket. No, please. Hold your applause. Hold your applause. Though, you know, you're right, because this is some fine work my hands are doing. Oh, ew. Oh, gross me out. And crossing the finish line, and voila! I did it! Yes, thank you very much. And to celebrate, I'd like to have you all over for a cocktail party at my beautiful home tonight.
Will there be shrimp?
Oh, boy. That's, it's quick recovery. How are you? Very, very good. Thank you very much. Thank you. Is he still? Yeah, he's still with us. All right, nicely done. Nicely done.
Thomas was soon teaching his techniques to surgical students at Johns Hopkins, but he was still paid as a technician, a fraction of Blaylock's salary. So Blaylock figured out a way to help Thomas make ends meet.
Viv Thomas, you have a surgical gift. Your sutures are God's own work. You could stitch up a wound before the blood hits the floor, but even more importantly, you make one hell of a daiquiri.
Somebody said daiquiri.
Thank you, Dr. Blaylock. You're too kind. Key is a small incision at the midpoint of the strawberry.
Yes, instead of pushing for Thomas to get a fair salary, Blaylock actually hired him as a bartender at his fancy parties.
You know, Viv, I just hate the fact that I make so much more money than you do, but here's the good news. My gutters are filthy, and I'd throw you a few bones if you got up there and cleaned them out. I think maybe a rat might have croaked up there or something. God only knows what's up there. Viv Thomas, Earth to Viv, Earth to Viv, come back to me. There you are, there you are. So what do you say? You come up there and clean him out for me?
Sure, Dr. Blaylock.
Oh, you are a good man. Take off early tonight.
But, sweetie, despite suffering the indignities of a system that didn't reward him for his brilliance, Vivien Thomas continued to innovate and train many future surgical department chiefs. And finally, at age 66, he was awarded an honorary doctorate from Johns Hopkins, and his former students commissioned a portrait to be hung next to Blaylock's in the lobby. But what you gotta think about is Thomas's most important legacy. I'm talking about the countless lives that he saved. Literally, sweetie, I'm talking about thousands of people who would have never lived past infancy. They all went on to enjoy long, meaningful lives thanks to the efforts of this man.